The Horse Stealer and Other Stories by Anton Chekhov. Narrated by Belinda Hillman. Gone Astray. A country village wrapped in the darkness of night. 1 o'clock strikes from the belfry. Two lawyers, called Kozovkin and Leev, both in the best of spirits and a little unsteady on their legs, come out of the wood and turn towards the cottages. "Well, thank God we've arrived," says Kozovkin, taking a deep breath. "Tramping 4 miles from the station in our condition is a feat. I am fearfully done up, and as ill luck would have it, not a fly to be seen." "Petya, my dear fellow, I can't. I feel like dying if I am not in my bed in 5 minutes." "In bed? Don't you do it, my boy. First, we'll have supper and a glass of red wine, and then you can go to bed. Verochka and I will wake you up." "Ah, my dear fellow, it's a fine thing to be married. You don't understand it, you cold-hearted wretch. I shall be home in a minute, worn out and exhausted. A loving wife will welcome me, give me some tea and something to eat, and repay me for my hard work and my love with such a fond and loving look out of her darling black eyes that I shall forget how tired I am and forget the burglary in the law courts and the appeal division. It's glorious." "Yes," I say, "I feel as though my legs were dropping off. I can scarcely get along. I'm frightfully thirsty." "Well, here we are at home." The friends go up to one of the cottages and stand still under the nearest window. "It's a jolly college," said Kozovkin. "You will see tomorrow what views we have. There's no light in the windows." "Verochka must have gone to bed then. She must have got tired of sitting up. She's in bed and must be worrying at my not having turned up." He pushes the window with his stick and opens it. "Plucky girl, she goes to bed without bolting the window." He takes off his cape and flings it with his portfolio in at the window. "I am hot. Let us strike up a serenade and make her laugh." He sings. "The moon floats in the midnight sky. Faintly stir the tender breezes. Faintly rustle in the treetops. Sing, sing, Holosha. Verochka, shall we sing you Schubert's serenade?" He sings. His performance is cut short by a sudden fit of coughing. "Tfu, Verochka, tell Aksinka to unlock the gate for us." A pause. "Verochka, don't be lazy. Get up, darling." He stands on a stone and looks in at the window. "Verochka, my dumpling. Verochka, my puppet. My little angel. My wife beyond compare. Get up and tell Ksenia to unlock the gate for us. You are not asleep, you know. Little wife, we are really so done up and exhausted that we're not in the mood for jokes. We've trudged all the way from the station. Don't you hear? Ah, hang it all." He makes an effort to climb up to the window and falls down. "You know this isn't a nice trick to play on a visitor. I see you are just as great a schoolgirl as ever. Vera, you are always up to mischief." "Perhaps Vera Stepanovna is asleep," says Leev. "She isn't asleep. I bet she wants me to make an outcry and wake up the whole neighborhood. I'm beginning to get cross, Vera. Ach, damn it all. Give me a leg up, Alyosha. I'll get in." "You are a naughty girl, nothing but a regular schoolgirl. Give me a hoist." Puffing and panting, Leev gives him a leg up. And Kosovskin climbs in at the window and vanishes into the darkness within. "Vera," Leev hears a minute later, "where are you?" "Damnation! Phew, I've put my hand into something. Phew!" There was a rustling sound, a flapping of wings, and the desperate cackling of a fowl. "Nice state of things," Leev hears. "Vera, where on earth did these chickens come from? Why, the devil, there's no end of them. There's a basket with a turkey in it. It pecks the nasty creature." Two hens fly out of the window, and cackling at the top of their voices, flutter down the village street. "Alyosha, we've made a mistake," says Kozovkin in a lachrymose voice. "There are a lot of hens here. I must have mistaken the house. Confound you, you're all over the place, you cursed brutes. Well, then, make haste and come down, do you hear? I am dying of thirst. In a minute, I'm looking for my cape and portfolio. Light a match.
The matches are in the cape. I was a crazy idiot to get into this place. The cottages are exactly alike. The devil himself couldn't tell them apart in the dark.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.